And as predicted, pro player football. He won. So he took the right away. I forgot to mention the mission right away, but instead we're only one person can attack at a time and get a point. The referee has to figure out who had the right away. So I put out, I did something to give me the right away for a minute. He hit my blade, which gave the right away to him, and then we both had, he wins and I lose. It's complicated. Oh, I'm watching now. So that time, he hesitated. How do you lose a right away? Well, lots of ways. One of them is you stop and you start moving backward. And so then I attacked, he parried, he stopped. I renewed my attack, hit him, my leg went off. Now all this is like, you know, you're viewing this like, what? So suffice to say, it's complicated, it's fun, it's an awful lot of fun. It's really fast, Saber is. And each person is trying to do the right thing the right way and have his leg go off and not the other one. And there are three weapons, three different sets of rules, three different sets of tactics. There's a saber, it's slashing, kind of slash, but I can stab. But mostly it's slash, blah, blah, blah. This came from horseback fighting. And there are five parries. There's a seventh one that's like this to keep the spike from cutting your head off as they come by on a horse. Yeah. The other two are foil and epic. The foil is a practice weapon. It's straight. It's a stabbing weapon. It's got a little tiny dart at your hand. The only target is the torso. Nothing else counts. Epee has a great big dart because the whole body area is a target area, and there's no right of way. So if you're old and tired and decrepit like me, then you're going to be an epic fencer. In fact, I've been one all my life. But if you're young and fast like him, you might be a saber fencer. And if you're, and foil's for either one, you can do anything. You can make a defensive game or an offensive game, still make it work. But in all situations, you're trying to stay in balance, you're trying to be ready. A lot of the games we play are designed to make you be on your toes, because if you get up here and you start dreaming about what you're going to do tomorrow night, you're going to get killed. Because this is very focused, what's he going to do to me, and what's am I going to do? They talk about the moment when you have a chance to make an attack. And if you're daydreaming, your moment's going to come and go. So that's the basics of fencing. Fencing is, above all, I'm trying to make sure that people have fun. But if they don't have fun, they won't do this for very long. At the same time, while you're having fun, you'll also learn how to do this, and you'll find that it's extremely fun once you know a little bit. The final thing is I want to make a community. I want people of all ages, from a child, from 9 years old, what am I saying, 9 years old up, to be able to talk with each other and have fun with each other and play with each other. We play a game every time during the club, and the goal is a 12-year-old can talk to a 17-year-old, and they know the lingo, so they can do that. And I did it in Monterey. They did do that. Yeah. So what I'm trying for is a community of people who like to do this, and